isn't that enough to get your attention? Jeez Louise. Anyway, the story goes on to say that so far this year, the FAA has reported at least 18 incidents involving lithium-ion batteries on planes, and in airports, there were 31 incidents. The story goes on to say that on any given flight, it may contain hundreds of lithium-ion cells in phones and laptops. We know that. And that many rechargeable devices involved in these fires, such as wireless headphones and especially e-cigarettes, they weren't even on the market a few years ago. Just last week, a JetBlue flight from New York to San Francisco was diverted to Grand Rapids for an emergency landing after an e-cigarette charger caught on fire. The brand was the eFest soda charger for e-cigarettes. So what can you do? What can passengers do? Consumer Reports recommends that your spare lithium-ion battery should not be stored loose in checked luggage, but rather put them onto a carry-on. And the whole idea is that if the battery catches fire, the problem will be noticed and handled quickly. And what should you do? The story actually says, what should you do if your battery-powered device begins heating up or even smoking while you're on board on a plane? What should you do? Consumer Reports says, notify the flight crew immediately. Yeah, I think we would do that. Coming up, we have our privacy tip, and it's 3 privacy and security mistakes to avoid while traveling this summer. And Diane in San Antonio, Texas.
Hi there. This has to do with downloading music. I live out in the country, and internet access is questionable at best. I have a Surface Pro 4 laptop and a SanDisk MP3 player, and I prefer to download my songs and put them on the MP3 player so I can listen to them.
Sure.
First, what site?